Hi everyone, how are you my dear children? Hope you all are safe and fine. Today we are going to discuss the application of dimensional analysis. Application of dimensional analysis. Under this, first we'll discuss the checking of correctness of an equation. Checking the correctness of an equation. What to do? Here what we'll do, we'll check the equation whether it is correct or not. How to do? Equation means there has to be some terms in left hand side and some terms in the right hand side of the equal sign. So LHS will be there, some terms, and RHS will be there. To check the correctness, we have to check the dimension of each term, and here also dimension of each term. If the dimension of each term of LHS equal to dimension of each term of RHS, then only our equation is correct. Let us see. We'll discuss some examples so that we can get this concept. So first example I am going to take, very easy, and in all the books this example is there because it is easy to visualize, because you have seen this equation from 9th class. Okay, first question: check the correctness of the equation S is equal to ut plus half at square. You have seen this. This is the equation of motion, where S is your displacement. S is displacement. U is your velocity. A is acceleration. And T is time. You have to check the correctness of this equation. That means this dimension and this dimension, it has to be equal. So let us start with LHS. S is your displacement, so that is distance. So dimension of S is simply L. Okay, now come to the first term of RHS, that is your UT. U, what is the dimension of velocity? L, T inverse. What is the dimension of T? Into T. You can write it to their 1 also over here. So what is the L, T minus T1. So it will get cancelled, because when you multiply this, power will get added up. So it is L. For your simplification, let me write like this. So it will become 0. That means L. Clear, children? Now what is half at square? What is the dimension of half? Any guesses? Half is a number, so it has got no dimension. So that means we have to only find out what is the dimension of A and what is the dimension of T square, then we have to multiply it. So dimension of A is your acceleration, that is L, T to the power minus 2, T is T to the power 2. So we are again going to get L. T to the minus 2 plus T to the power. T to the minus 2 plus 2. Like here what you have calculated over here. So same way you will calculate, and you are again going to get the same dimension. See, LHS L. RHS first term also L. Again half it is square also L. So this equation is, therefore equation is correct. Done? what is the limitation over here? Anybody? Any guesses? See children, half a t square, dimension is L. If I'll write a t square or if I'll write 280 square, is it going to change the dimension? But it is going to change the equation. If in place of half a t square, I'll write just a t square, is this equation will be correct? So this is the limitation of this method. This equation is dimensionally correct, but equation need not be actually correct. So that means a dimensionally correct equation need not be a correct equation, but dimensionally wrong equation definitely wrong equation. Have you noted it down? If the equation is dimensionally not correct, then that equation is definitely not correct. But here, as you can see, it is dimensionally equation is correct. But if I change the number over here, then equation is not correct. Dimensionally correct, but equation is not correct. This is the limitation of this method. Okay, children? We'll go to the next question. What is your next question? Please practice all the dimensions. Since you are new to this dimension thing, please practice it. You have to again check the correctness of your equation. Next question. V is equal to pi p, okay? Then pi p a square minus x square divided by 2 eta l. What is this pi? This is a number where v is velocity. Let me write over here. V is velocity. P is pressure difference. P is pressure difference. Okay? And your A is radius of the tube. Radius of the tube. And X is the distance from the axis of the tube. Distance from the axis of the tube. What is eta? Any guesses? We have already discussed. This is nothing but coefficient of viscosity. Coefficient of viscosity. What is L? Easily you can guess, that is the length of the tube. Length of the tube. Please note down this question and try to solve on your own. Try to solve on your own. If you are not getting, then I am waiting. Okay? Please try to solve as quickly as possible. Let me see how many of you can solve this. Check the correctness of the equation. Let me start. Done. Tried. LHS. What is LHS? Velocity. What is the dimension of velocity? Just now we have done. M0, L to the power 1, T to the power minus 1. Is it clear? Is it correct? Am I correct? Then RHS. What is RHS? Pi P A square minus X square divided by 2 eta L. What is this? Pi is not having any dimension. What is P? Pressure. Pressure is force per area. Force per area. Let me write over here. Force per area. So it will be M L to the power minus 1 T to the power minus 2. Okay. This is the dimension of pressure. And this is both are length only. Okay. Both are length. We have already studied. You can only subtract or add the same dimension wala terms. So simply this is L square. 2 eta L. Again 2 is not having. This is number. So it is a dimensionless quantity. What is eta? M to the power 1. L to the power minus 1. T to the power. What? Please. What is this? T to the power minus 1 and L is simply L. Please solve this. What answer you are getting? Let me know. What answer you are getting? M, here M, here M. So it will get cancelled. That means M 0. Here L to the power minus 1 and L to the power 2. That means L to the power minus 1. Here it is L minus 1 plus 1. Sorry. L to the power minus 1 into L to the power 2. So L to the power 1. Because here minus 1 plus 1 get cancelled. So this time, this is normal 3, 4, 5 class mathematics. And T to the power minus 2. So T to the power minus 2, when this will go up, it will be plus 1. That means T to the power minus 1. Check LHS and RHS. Same? Same. That means dimensions on both the sides are same. So equation is correct. This is your correct equation. Dimensionally correct equation. Should you solve another one? So we'll get a practice. Let me solve another question. Under the same heading, that means dimensionally becoming, this board is becoming very dirty. Let me clean it out. Okay, I have cleaned it. So we are ready for the next question. Again, check the correctness of the equation, that is your delta. Delta is equal to mg L cube divided by 4 b d cube L. This is the equation you will get in your properties of solids. What is delta? Delta is nothing but depression in the middle of the bar. So delta is depression. Depression. In the middle of the, write down, in the middle of a bar of length, that bar is having length L, breadth B, and depth, this is your depth D. Suppose this is your bar, in the middle if you are hanging a mass M, if it is loaded with the mass M, this bar will depress. It will depress like this. Okay, you will study in properties of solids. So D is the depth and it is loaded in the middle of the bar with mass M. This is your mass. Okay, here this is not length, this is Y. Okay, this is your length L, 4BD³Y, because Y is your Young's modulus of elasticity. Elasticity chapter children, Young's modulus of material of the bar. This is your data given. You have to check the correctness of the equation. So delta is the depression. So what is the dimension of delta? Any guesses? Depression. That means again some length. It is getting depressed by some length. So dimension again for delta will be L. So you can write also either this, or you can write like this, M0 L1 E to the power 0. Is it clear? Then RHS. RHS is your M G L Q 4 B D Q Y. How to do? M you know, M mass, simply M. What is G? You know small g, acceleration due to gravity. L cube, L cube. Done, easy, easy. 4, it has got no dimension. Again, breadth. Breadth means again length. Depth, D to the power cube. So, L to the power cube. What is the dimension of Y? Anybody, any guesses? Young's modulus of elasticity. So, it will be stress by strain. This will be stress by strain. And we know strain has got no dimension. That means we have to find out only the dimension of stress. What is this stress? Stress is nothing but force per area. Okay, so this is your one, no dimension. So what is stress? That is your force per area. So what is force? What is force? Dimension of force. ML t to the power minus 2. Area is L square. This is the dimension of stress. So how much it is? M, let me do over here. M 1 L to the power minus 1 T to the power minus 2. So this is your dimension of Young's modulus of elasticity. M to the power 1 L to the power minus 1 T to the power minus 2. Put over here. M 1 L to the power minus 1 T to the power minus 2. Now solve it. This is simple mathematics. Okay. M get cancelled. M 0. This is your L to the power 4. This is your also L to the power 4. So this L to the power 4. This L to the power 4 get cancelled. L to the power minus 1 will go up. So it will be L to the power 1. So T to the power minus 2. T to the power minus 2. It will again get cancelled. So T to the power 0. So dimensionally equation is correct. See, LHS is equal to RHS. Is it clear, children? Okay. Okay. Now we'll move to the next application of dimension analysis, that is your conversion of unit. Very big heading, conversion of units. Now I am scared. Now everybody is scared. What is this? This is the easiest topic. What is this? Conversion of units. You know, we have already studied any physical quantity PQ, I'll make it a symbol Q, is equal to N into U. This thing we have studied already. We have discussed this thing in my first lecture of dimension, N into U. Okay, conversion of units, nothing. Q is equal to, you can say N1 into U1 is equal to N2 into U2. What are these quantities? This is your physical quantities you are going to measure or you are going to discuss. What is this N1? Nothing. Suppose 5 meter. We have studied in class 3 or 4 is equal to 500 centimeter. So this is your N2, this is your U2. That means we are just changing our systems. Here from MKS system to CGS system. Nothing great. This is simple. This N1 is your numerical value, that is 5. U1 is a system, unit in a system. Now this is a unit in a different system. Okay, children. Here, what will happen? Let me erase it. You have to here, you have to find out any, like suppose N1, U1 is given and you have to convert into U2. We will see the question, then you will find it out. You can find N2. When these three quantities are known, you can easily find out N2. So what is N2? N2 is equal to N1, U1 by U2. Is it clear? N1, U1 by U2. What is this N1, N2? We know N1 and N2 are, what is this N1 and N2? These are the respective numerical values of any fundamental quantity. What is U1 and U2? These are the units of measurements of quantity Q. These are two types of units in two different systems. Okay, have you noted it down? U1 and U2 are the two units of measurement of quantity Q. N1 and N2 are the respective numerical values. Okay, then fundamental unit is mass, length, time. Okay, so we can express U1 as M to the power 1 to the power A, L to the power 1 to the power B, T to 1 to the power C. We'll express U1 like this. And we will express U2 like this, M2 to the power A, L2 to the power B and T2 to the power C. these M1, L1, T1. These are the fundamental units of mass, length and time in one system. M2, L2, T2, these are the again fundamental units of mass, length, time in another system. And this A, B, C are nothing but their respective dimensions of the quantity of mass, length, time. Okay, then what is this M2 now? Can I write N2 over here? Anybody? What is N1? You have to write N1. Then U1, that means M1 by M2 to the power A. Then L1 by L2 to the power B. Then T1 by T2 to the power C. This is your formula. Okay? Just put these values over here and you will get it. Clear? Now we'll discuss 1-2 questions because these are the easiest questions of this chapter. Let me discuss. First question. Convert 1 Newton into dial. Convert 1 Newton into dial. How much dial? We don't know. That N2, that means we have to find out. Here it is N1 and here it is U1 and this is your U2. That means we are converting MK system into CGS system. Okay? And we know what is the Newton, this unit for which physical quantity? Here we are. Which physical quantity actually this question is referring to? Newton, that means force. So we are discussing about force. So what is the dimension of force? Any guesses? ML T^-2. Am I correct or am I wrong? Okay. So from here, tell me what is A. A is equal to 1. B is equal to 1. And C is equal to -2. Hope I am clear with this. Okay. We have to convert 1 Newton to dial. Okay. 1 Newton to, suppose I am converting 1 Newton to 1 dial. Now here N1 is equal to 1. N2 we don't know. How much dial it will be, we have no idea. Tell me, M1 means what is the unit? Kg. Okay. What is this kg? It will be 1 kg. Then L1 will be how much? 1 meter. Then T1. How much? 1 second. Here, what is M2? 1 gram CGS system. What is L2? 1 centimeter. What is till now it is clear? So, what we'll do? We'll use our formula. N2 is equal to N1 M1 by M2A. Then L1 by L2 B. Then T1 by T2 C. Okay? T1 T2 by C. Now put it. What is M1? That is your 1 kg. So N2 will be 1 kg divided by 1 gram to the power. What is? A, B, C. 1 minus 2. Okay? So we'll write 1. In place of 1, 1 meter by 1 centimeter, it will be again raised to the power 1, then 1 second by 1 second raised to the power of minus 2. Sorry, here I have missed 1 N1. Okay, so what is your N2? So N2 will be how much? Tell me. N1 we know 1. 1 kg means how many grams? 1000. So 1000 by 1. So it will be 1000 only. So I can write 10 to the power cube. 1000 I can express in 10 to the power cube. So 10 to the power cube gram by 10, 1 gram to the power 1. Then 1 meter, that means how many centimeter? 100 centimeter. So I can write 10 to the power 2 by 1 centimeter to the power 1. 1 second, 1 second. What? This is simply nothing but
What?
1 second by 1 second to the power minus 2. Now n2 is equal to 10 to the power q. So we'll write simply 10 to the power q because it is power 1. Then 10 to the power 2. What is this? 1 by 1, 1. 1. So it is again 1. So that means this is 10 to the power 5. So 1 newton is equal to 10 to the power 5 dyne. In class 6, 7th or 8th you have studied this. Now you got the proof how it is 1 newton is equal to 10 to the power 5 dyne. Is it clear, children? Now we will discuss another question, that will be the last question of this video. Okay, on conversion of units, so that in my next lecture we will be discussing a different topic. What is that topic? We will be discussing a very important lecture, will be the next video lecture. You have to convert. What is the question? Universal gravitational constant. You have seen this universal gravitational constant in class 9th. So G is equal to 6.67 into 10 to the power, how much? Minus 11. Is it correct? What is the unit? Newton meter square per kg square. What is the unit? Newton meter square per kg square. So this is your universal gravitational constant. You have to find its value in CGS system. So first, to start with, you have to find out the dimension formula of capital G. That is your m to the power minus 1, l to the power 3, t to the power minus 2. This is your dimensional formula of capital G. So here n1 is given, 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11, but n2 we have to find out. Okay, similar way, just start. m1 is equal to 1 kg, l1 is equal to 1 meter, t1 is equal to 1 second. Here, in similar way, m2 is equal to 1 gram, l2 is equal to 1 centimeter, t2 is equal to 1 second. Okay? And what is your a? A is equal to minus 1, b is equal to 3, and c is equal to minus 2. So put it. n2 is equal to n1, m1, by m2, a, then l1 by l2, b, then t1 by t2, c. Okay, now put it. n2 is equal to n1, m1 by m2, that means 1 kg by 1 gram to the power minus 1, then here 1 meter by 1 centimeter to the power 3, then 1 second by 1 second to the power minus 2. Okay, now we'll move further with our calculation. Let me erase this. So n2 is equal to n1 is given, 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11. 1 kg, again in similar way, we'll write 10 to the power 3 to the power minus 1, then 10 to the power 2 to the power 3, then 1 second in 1 second. So, 1 second by 1 second, I can write it simply 1. So, how much it is? 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11, 10 to the power 3 into 2 to the power minus 1, so we can write 10 to the power minus 3. Here it will be 10 to the power 6. So how much it is? 6.67 into 10 to the power how much? Minus 11 minus 3 minus 14 plus 6. So it will be minus 8. Is it clear? Then it will be dyne centimeter square gram square. Is it clear, children? Practice as many questions as you are getting in different books. And do it. If any doubt, if you are facing any problem, please let me know. Leave a comment in comment section box so that I can address your doubts. Hope it is clear. Okay? Take care, children. And thank you for watching, children.